I've got exciting things to tell you about Galan. Galan is it's part of the lithium revolution that is going to take over the battery industry, and that's why lithium it's so much you hear on the news. It's everywhere because we've seen something unprecedented for the last I'll say 100 years, and that is that we've seen batteries everywhere, and we've seen batteries in cars, and that's the main driver as why lithium is important. Today, we'll see pretty much that the combustion engine is going to be outphased or retired from the market. And the last time we saw something like that was almost 100 years ago when horses got retired from the everyday life in the industry. And so it's something that none of us has ever lived. And this is big, and it's a big transformation of what we've seen. But more to the point, the market is interesting, yes. We've seen that the market is taking lithium as a newcomer. There's all this interest in the market in lithium, but this is about Galan. Why Galan? Galan, it's I'm the managing director and founder of this company. Started 4 years ago. Needless to say, I've got a fantastic team in Argentina, Chile, and also I've got a very supportive board here in Australia. And our main focus today is Argentina. Why Argentina? For the last 4 years, we've been working hard to take our projects to advance them as much as possible. And the fundamental things about Galan is that it's a project that's got high grade, low and low impurities. That setting is unique. You cannot find that easily as part of nature everywhere. So, in other words, if you've been in mining for a while, grade is king. We have approximately 3 million tons of lithium carbonate equivalent in ground in between two projects, and our flagship project is called Hombre Muerto West. We have taken this project into a study phase that we're now moving into our DFS and promptly to start. But one of the things that I'd like to highlight as well is that Argentina today has been really busy, and we've seen a lot of action happening everywhere. And one of those things is that we're seeing the merger of Orocobre and Galaxy, and there's going to be a new company that is as big as Pilbara Minerals, by the way. So it's not a small joint venture. We've seen that Millennium has been taken over by Ganfeng and then outbid by CATL. Then we have the transaction that is pending to be approved with Neo Lithium for a significant amount of Canadian dollars, $960 million to be exact. And all of this is just happening within this month. I would like to highlight that Galan Lithium is, from where I stand, the last lithium project in Argentina, and that it has no JVs, no deals with anyone, and it's 100% owned by Galan. So if you want to go look for lithium in Argentina, that it's got a path to develop for lithium carbonate, then there's no one else. So. And this give us place us in a good position for the future deals that we can make do in the future. And as we haven't done any JV agreements or offtake agreement, as we develop the project, we can walk into a better commercial solution for what we want to do. And what do we want to do? The study showed that we can produce from Hombre Muerto West, that's our flagship project, the study done with Worley, it showed that we can do 20,000 tons of lithium carbonate for 40 years with a low OPEX of $3,500 a ton, a CAPEX of around $440 million, including a large contingency of $100 million that should be reduced down the track. But these numbers these days are a few and far in between because there's not much left in the market that I can independently say that production can be achieved. And for such, we're going with a very simple method of evaporation. I understand that this technology out there is promising a lot of things, but today there's nothing replacing the evaporation process. It's a low risk, low CapEx, it has low OpEx. We don't need energy. Remember, all Lithium Triangle projects are in the middle of nowhere. So access to water and access to power doesn't come easy. It's not actually there. New technologies are promising many solutions, but if you take into account all the things that I mentioned before, then it raises a risky profile. And on top of that, potentially reinjection of brines, is something totally unknown. So we take the known approach to produce lithium carbonate from a known solution, something that works for 40 years. We're trying to improve it, make it better, to increase recoveries and to reduce OpEx. Anyway, where we are today, we raised funds a couple of months ago and finalized that last week. And the money is going to be put together for all the studies that are required for Hombre Muerto West. That, in other words, we're drilling today for reserves. We are moving into start a pilot plant to demonstrate the points that I mentioned before, and to do the engineering. There's going to be a award is imminently coming for showing that we have a robust case, a commercial case to produce lithium carbonate at site. But interesting enough, we may have another way of getting to market quicker, and I'll go more into the rest of the presentation. The money also will be deployed for doing the same thing at Candelas, and overall, Candelas is stage two, if you want to call it. So, Hombre Muerto West has a profile today of 20,000 tons as per study. We believe we could get to 25,000 tons of lithium carbonate as the next study phase that we can get, and Candelas could have somewhere between 10 to 15,000 tons of lithium carbonate equivalent. So you can call it that stage two if you want. A combination of both projects could give us a long-term profile in the future of around 40,000 tons of lithium carbonate equivalent, and that is a similar profile that it's looking at Lithium Americas to produce today. So the value that we can add and show within two stages of Hombre Muerto West and Candelas, it shows that Galan, it could be a relatively large lithium company with a healthy EBITDA and with a long-term investment for our shareholders. And more to where we are, just want to show you that we are in the Lithium Triangle, and also to say who our neighbors are. Our neighbors are POSCO, Galaxy, and Oro Copper now, and Livent. It's a company that has proven that Hombre Muerto can produce lithium carbonate and lithium hydroxide, if you want to go that way. They've been on the market for 28 years. The lithium revolution for the Sony Handycam started at Hombre Muerto, where Livent is. So lithium is something that started the lithium revolution a while ago. But more to the point that I started, grade is king. In this chart, you can see that the grade is king in salt flats in Argentina. Hombre Muerto West is the far right balloon that you can see there, followed by all the other projects at the Hombre Muerto Basin again. So you got POSCO, Galaxy, and Livent following Galan. But if you look at on the left axis, you also will see the lithium impurities to magnesium on the left and the left axis. The interesting thing here is that you want to be as low on the left side and as far right as you can, and Galan is showing that you can do. So in other words, it translates that we can have down the track an operation with low risk, because grade can help you to manage operations better, and there will be challenges, and we are preparing ourselves for those. And if you look at more impurities in the next slide that I'm showing, you have magnesium to lithium, and then if you replace grade, you will see sulfur to lithium. Now, where would you like to be? You would like to be as close as zero as you can be. And then you find a cluster, and that cluster is Hombre Muerto and all the companies that I previously mentioned are our neighbors. In other words, it shows that the level of impurities at Galan are the same as POSCO, Galaxy, and Livent. The main difference that we have a little higher grade than them. And this is the key thing as why POSCO, like 2 years ago, bought the northern part of Galaxy for $280 million. At the time, that looked like a ridiculous money, too expensive. Today, everybody's looking at that transaction. How could it be so cheap? So I'll leave you with that to think about the impurities, and the setting is very important. More to now, the next slide is about the ESG. Needless to say, the operations today for the evaporation process, and this is courtesy of SQM, it shows that the ESG, or the carbon footprint in this case, coming from brines is lower than hard rock. And this is going to be a more important thing as time passes by, because the main reason why you can do this is because you use the sun to your advantage. And the next slide shows the energy intensity, and that reflects that the sun doesn't charge us. The lithium comes in a solution. We don't have to crush screen process, concentrate, roast, do a lot of things to get to a lithium carbonate product. It's a low energy intensive process, and that's why the carbon footprint can be so low. So in other words, there is a way forward for lithium that from brines that it can show that is a better option for the future in terms of carbon footprint. And this is something that we currently engage a company to do this study. We don't just want to work with numbers from third parties, we're doing this ourselves. So a snapshot about the company, highly held 289 million shares on issue. We don't have billions of shares on issue. The management's got 17% of the company, top 20 is 48, and top 50 is around 60% of the company. It's the free float is very tight. And we have 15 million and a half as the last quarterly when reported. We should have a position of around 60 plus million now that we complete the last raise. In relation to our board, I would like to highlight that Daniel Jimenez, the third man from left to right, is the person that has the most lithium experience in our board. He worked for 28 years for SQM, 10 years as a senior VP of commercial. So he is someone that knows brine back and forth, knows the market, and has been instrumental in all the advances that we're making. People ask, what is he doing behind the scenes? He's got a lot of contacts and that help us to fast track the study, the hydrogeology, and even the context that we're talking on these days to get them in a very strong position. So Daniel, I keep insisting, is a key man in our group. And I'm very pleased to see the results that he can bring to us. Now, the satellite picture of Hombre Muerto, where we at, and Hombre Muerto is a large basin, as you can see. The map starts on the left with Hombre Muerto West. We move to the right, we got Livent in red. Further north to the right, we see POSCO. Then to the south, we see Galaxy and Oro Cobre joint venture. Further south, we see Candelas. As you can see, we have two projects in the same basin that is high grade, low impurities, and you could call it Hombre Muerto West Stage 1 and Candelas Stage 2 for simplicity. The combination of these can make Galan operations, our future operations and project, as a large project of up to 40,000 tons of lithium carbonate equivalent. That's a key message that I would like you to remind it on keep thinking. And then this is the study that we've done with Worley. We churned up 20,000 tons of lithium carbonate equivalent a year on ponds. Can be all done in our ground. We don't have to ask permission for a third party. And on the picture on the left, it can show us how competitive the study shows that Hombre Muerto West could be. If we were to go to produce today, we would be one of the lowest operating costs on the lithium cost curve. A comparison now to Australian companies and Lithium Americas, so you can see we have a very competitive OpEx, and also our CapEx is work in progress. Now we're going to improve even beyond to what we're seeing. So this information you can download and see at your own leisure further, and ask me questions at any other time you would like. I'm all accessible, and my contacts are on our webpage. But furthermore, at Hombre Muerto West, what else can we do? We're not stopping thinking of where can we improve? And pretty much we've seen that Hombre Muerto West has now a footprint for ponds of up to 25,000 tons. And that's what I mentioned early on. And you can see the different colors of stage one and two within Hombre Muerto West as what we can do to develop up to 25,000 tons. We have more ground, by the way, that we can use on the other end of the ridge to increase our production if we, for whatever reason, we've seen that our conversion to reserve is fantastic. But for the time being, this is where we're at. We acquire more ground. We're trying to increment our resources statement and also come out with a maiden study for reserves. So one of the commercial things that I would like to show that we've done within the studies and all the work that we've done behind the scenes and we announced to the market as well is that our concentrate, the ponds that you see there, can concentrate up to 6% lithium chloride concentrate. In other words, we could use to our advantage the Australian view of producing lithium concentrate and then sell it either to our neighbors or export it. This is something that we're definitely exploring because we see there is a value to it. It means two things. We can come to market instead of 5 years, we can reduce that to three, and our CapEx from 440, it could be reduced to around $200 to $250 million. So all becomes more doable from Galan's point of view, and this is something that we're going to explore to try to apply the Australian model, concentrate and sell it, get cash flow and reduce the risk and produce lithium carbonate down the track if that's a requirement that we believe that is going to add more value. Now, in terms of what we've done tests and we keep doing testing, testing, testing. So we are starting to evaporate in that site. It's something that we are very excited about. And lastly, I would like to say that we are doing geophysics and soil sampling at the Greenbushes South joint venture. We have a project down there that is very interesting in terms of its prospectivity. So with that said, I will conclude my presentation. But one of the things that I would like to say about Galan is that we're very approachable. We have something very going forward. There's a lot of things that I would like to say, but my contact details are there. Please reach out anytime. I'm happy to engage one-on-one, explain further details of things that you'd like to know from us. So with that, thanks very much, Clive, and I wish everyone a good day.